What is good, folks? Back with another video. Can't lie. I'm extremely tired right now. You know, it's all the time. It's very early, but we got to get to the airport quite early because the flight is in like morning, mid afternoon, well, almost mid. Yeah, morning. I'm chatting rubbish. It's in the morning. So, you know, got to wake up early, get down there. So, I'm about to shower and stuff, get my bags downstairs. And then head off to the airport. So, there I go. All right, so I just finished getting ready. I'm still a bit, I'm awake, but I'm not awake. But we got to take on this journey. 10 hours again. What the heck was that, man? 10 hours again, back to Grenada. Stopping off in St. Lucia for like a little bit, letting the people off, and then on to Grenada. I'm flying from Gatwick, I'm flying from Gatwick, I believe. that's not very good to say, I believe, when I'm just flying. Yeah, I'm flying from Gatwick. And then, we're going to go from there. But it's still early. Sometimes I prefer the early flights because you kind of get, you know, out of the way and you reach your destination, you know, in a decent time prepared for, like, later flights later on in the day where you kind of don't have any time to do anything once you get there. So gonna make sure the house is locked up before I leave, and that'll be it, man. So there you go. So while I'm waiting for my sister a nice cup of tea, ooh, that should perk me up just a little bit. I'm not extremely tired, but you know, I'm still a little bit tired, man. But we're chilling, we're vibing, we're ready to go back to Grenada, man. England right now is fake hot. And by fake hot, it says one thing on, you know, on the weather app. When you step outside, it's not that temperature. So I'm not feeling that. I don't respect that. And Grenada, at least when it says it's hot, even if it's the wrong temperature, it's still hot. You're still sweating, you know. So I've had a good old time in the UK. I did what I needed to do while I was here. So, it's only right I head back over to the sunny side of the world. You know? And a lot of people find 10 hours like a long distance, but I've travelled quite a lot throughout my years. So, it's kind of normal to me now, like 8, 10 hours, whatever. Especially when you've like gone to the US and stuff and all that sort of thing. So, it is what it is at this point. I'm going to finish this cup of tea. Hopefully my sister will be here by then. She's taking me to the airport. And then, you know, we just go from there. We get some shots on the way to the airport and see what the airport's saying. I don't think it should be too crazy because right now it's like not school holidays. So maybe and hopefully the flight is empty. I can chill, put my feet up. There's no one next to me because I've never, ever had that, I don't think. Actually, only once. I think when I was traveling with my mum, there was a space in between us, able to kind of stretch out. But yeah, I've never had like a full aisle to myself. I know some people, like, they get on planes, it's completely empty and they can just lay down. So hopefully I get something close to that. When I was picking my seat, I saw like my aisle was empty. So let's hope nobody joins me, you know what I'm saying? So let me finish a cup of tea and then keep you guys updated.
At the roundabout, take the fourth exit to merge onto the M25
south. I feel like
I'm
one of the most handsome men in the world.
I know you do. It's weird. It's weird that you look in the mirror and get bang on yourself.
I said look in the mirror. It's because I used to listen in religion when we got that new teacher. She did not play. Had to focus up, had to realise that, say Miss Sweeney no more. What was her name? Miss something. She used to make her stand up when she came in the room. Good afternoon, Miss. Sit down. No, did I say sit down? She used to smile. All right, you may all be seated. But we actually just got into the habit. We was unruly that class. So unruly. I don't know why they gave us that teacher before. She was just weak. This one?
Who's ever made a teacher cry?
I think literally she was on the verge of crying. She was young.
She must have been doing nursery kids before, and then they gave her one on a really religion class. Checked in now. I thought my bag might have got stopped because I had some electronical items that they might have found a bit shifty, but got through, man. It was calm. Security checks done. I'm just waiting to get my gate information at like 10 something, I think it is. So I'm gonna chill out for a little bit. I bought some food. Boy, I almost left my food in the shop. I walked away and then I saw the, looked at my bag. I was like, wait, there's no food in here. I have to go back. My food was sitting there on the self-service checkout. I was thinking, right, people could have nabbed my food, but the woman there gave it to me straight away. So, yeah, I must be tired, man. But yeah, I'm going to just chill for now, man. Airport is mad busy, so it is what it is, man. So I'm heading to my gate now. I won't lie, the sleep is touching me, man. I almost fell asleep in my seat, but heading to the gate now, should be boarding soon, and then obviously flight taking off very soon. Can't wait to sit down in my seat and go to sleep, because man's done. Chauffeur. You know what I mean by private. What do you mean? That's a nice thing to say. Mm-hmm. Okay, my favorite chauffeur.
What? You have more than one now, okay.
You and my sister. She's my UK one, you're my Grenada one. I feel like I just annoy women in life.
Yeah, I think that's one of your colleagues.
I wouldn't say special skills. But you all love.
Some guys are really bold. I'm sure one guy winked at the air hostess. I was like, bro, really? You can't be serious.
It's 1 through 80, but I would never want to be your
air. If I had slept when I first got on the plane, mm-hmm. I'd have slept all the way through. But they kept giving us food. And I was like, this is great. But at the same time, it wasn't as good as last time. It was, no, the wrap was there. But it was like pasta, gnocchi, and something.
and the portion size was a lot smaller.
In the wrap?
No. They were two separate things.
Oh,
so
that's a confusing wrap.
Yeah, the wrap was trash. It was like some vegetable wrap. But it was like, the inside was too hot, so it made the wrap soggy.
Yeah.
So I was like, this is not really enjoyable. I can eat it, but it's not enjoyable. The gnocchi thing was good. It just needed some more stuff in it. Like in the actual meal itself, it was like tomato gnocchi and some spinach.